Another thing is when we are studying those things, we need to think about making contact not only with one point, but with the whole body of the robot, as the robot is interacting, immersed in that environment. So all of that makes it very, very challenging. I mean, you have to think, humans are amazing. I mean, when you study those problems, you realize how amazing our hand is, how amazing our capability to coordinate is. And in here, you need to control the posture, you need to control the task, you need to control the contact, you need to control the constraints, so many constraints on the robot, you need to balance. How we do it? How human manage to do it? Well, we discover actually humans are really, really smart at this. I'm forgetting about everything. I'm just going to focus on my hand reaching. Suddenly my shoulder feels that my hand is extended and I need to move my body. I control the posture separately but in coordination with the task. We studied this problem and we came up with an algorithm that allows us to implement this as a whole body controller. Now, with a whole body controller, we were able to implement things that even human would have difficulty to do, such as, imagine you are making contact with slippery surfaces and you have to maintain normal contact, otherwise you will fall. And to do that, you have to maintain all these reaction forces inside these friction cones, we call them. This is remarkable in the ability of the robot to adapt, to sense, to feel, and control all its interaction with the environment.